Hey everyone, CTN Technology News here, and today I'm reviewing the Microsoft Surface 2, which is a definite upgrade over 2012 Surface RT. It's faster with a sharper screen and houses better cameras. If you're choosing between the older and newer model, the newer is the decidedly better option even with its $100 premium. A far more appropriate question, however, is whether a Surface tablet in general is right for you. Now, there are two main issues with the Surface 2 that keep it from achieving true excellence. First, with the notable exception of Microsoft Office 2013, Windows RT is still not compatible with legacy Windows programs. In other words, any old Windows program that works on your XP, Vista, or Windows 7 PC won't work here. Second, although the Windows App Store has made some gains in app breadth and depth since its debut last year, it still lags painfully behind app stores from Amazon, Apple, and Google. Those seeking legacy software compatibility can opt instead for the Surface Pro 2, which delivers the same overall look and feel of the Surface 2, but runs the full version of Windows 8.1. But there will be compromises. You'll pay twice as much, lose the free Office bundle, get shorter battery life, and get a tablet that's thicker and heavier than the Surface 2. Meanwhile, even at $449, the Surface 2 itself is pretty expensive for a tablet with its aforementioned software limitations, and there are already other viable options for a $349 tablet with a keyboard running full Windows 8.1. Though Microsoft offers a better package than it did last year, the Surface 2 ultimately suffers from the same problems as the original, and until the company can better address those issues inherent to Windows RT and the Windows Store in particular, this will continue to be the case. So let's talk briefly about design. So Microsoft has put a new color onto the Surface 2, a new silver-gray backside that, you know, it's not going to be that big a difference, but it just shows that you've got the new model. Besides that, the design is a little bit slimmer and, you know, it looks a little bit better. But let's move on to the new touch and type covers, which are probably more important anyways. Both the new touch and type covers are still sold separately at $119 and $129 respectively, but now include a useful backlighting feature. They're also thinner than before and feel a bit more comfortable than used. When used as covers, the whole package doesn't feel quite as thick. Now let me talk about Windows RT 8.1. Now Windows RT, even in its shinier version 8.1 form, is still the poor man's version of Windows 8.1, essentially. It still won't run legacy programs, but anything found in the Windows Store is fair game. It does, however, include a full version of Microsoft Office 2013. Now, it's clear that Microsoft has thought about what makes a good interface, which is where it should which is where it basically went wrong with the original touch interface from 2012. Things still aren't perfect this year, but Microsoft has made some sensible and thoughtful changes that noticeably improve the flow and efficiency of interacting with apps and settings. Previously, accessing your array of apps was a two-step process. Swipe up from the bezel and tap all apps, but now simply swiping up from the home screen takes you directly to the array. This is an example of one of the small but significant changes in Windows RT 8.1. And this is the sort of change that makes Windows RT 8.1 a lot better. Now let me talk about the Windows Store makeover. Now the Windows Store gets a cleaner, somewhat sophisticated, and flatter look in Windows 8.1 RT. Microsoft has chosen to pull back a bit and not put quite as much information out on you, giving you the choice of finding it yourself. Promoted lists are a bit more focused and, you know, it feels more specifically chosen. Now, user reviews of individual apps are more prominent and useful. You can now see just how many 5-star, 4-star, 3-star reviews have been posted for the app in question. So, while I'm talking about Windows Store, let me talk about app availability. Now, the Surface RT, the original one, was definitely lacking in apps, and that was probably the major drawback for the RT. Now, things have definitely improved in the last year. There are a lot more apps in the Windows Store, including official Facebook and Twitter apps. There are plenty of cool apps for cooking, but for instance, there's no official YouTube app yet. The holes are being filled, but it will take a while for the Windows Store to catch up to either iOS or Android. Now, as far as performance on the Surface RT 2, by including a Tegra 3 in the Surface RT, at the time, Microsoft kind of underestimated the appeal of having a powerful graphics processor in the tablet. The Surface 2 thankfully houses a much more powerful 1.7 GHz Tegra 4 processor. This is the same Tegra 4 that HP put in its SlateBook X2, and the performance is very similar. The page loads on the Surface 2 are decent for, you know, a tablet especially, but even in comparison to like a Windows 8.1 PC, they're not bad. Now in conclusion, the Surface 2 enters a more competitive and intimidating market than the Surface RT did last year. Obviously it's improved, but you know, the question is it really a viable alternative to a full Windows 8.1 PC or a tablet? The problem is it just falls in between. It's a very cool device and I really like the Surface 2, but if you're in the market for a tablet, you're not going to like the lack of apps, and if you're in the market for a PC, you're not going to like the limitations on the Surface 2. It really comes down to whether you're looking specifically for a Surface or whether you're looking for a more general category. Let me know what you want in the Surface 2 or whether you'll buy the Surface 2 in the comments below. Please be sure to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time. Bye!